Hey guys, today is our topic about the action potential. Action potential, a potential at which impulses pass into the cell membrane. Outside the cell membrane is a more positive charge because the concentration of sodium, calcium is high, and inside the cell membrane it is more negative. Why the cell is more negative inside the cell membrane? The reason is this, because there is a negatively charged or present of protein, carbohydrates and the lipids into the cell membrane, which maintain or which keep the cell into negatively charged. And the resting membrane potential we are going to share is here is -70 millivolt. This one is a resting membrane potential. At this condition, the cell is at rest. The definition of the resting membrane potential is simply this: the potential at which the cell is rest is known as a resting membrane potential. And for example, when we will apply any stimuli, for example, I simply touch a marker on my finger, but it doesn't able to apply a action potential. What's the reason? The reason is this: only the action potential will be occur when the resting membrane potential will go into threshold membrane potential. Here -50 millivolt is threshold membrane potential. For example, I simply touch here with the bone marker on my finger. I'm just giving a simple example, and the voltage of this is 10. So if from -70, then this will become of -60, and -60 is not enough to produce of the action potential. What's the reason? The reason is this, because the resting membrane potential didn't reach to the threshold membrane potential. Even in many exams, MCQs, the question come related to the threshold membrane potential. It is necessary for production of the action potential that the cell membrane should go to the threshold membrane potential. From the threshold membrane potential, if a stimuli have membrane potential of the 10, another one have a 50, we can sum up 25, and it will be more than -50 when it will cross the threshold membrane potential. When it will cross the threshold membrane potential, then it is able to produce of the action potential. It is produce of the action potential. Then what happened? And the below the threshold membrane potential, what's the stimuli is called, or what's the condition is known as a sub-threshold stimuli. These are the stimuli are the sub-threshold, because these stimuli are not able to reach to the threshold. Again, I will tell you that it is necessary for the production of the action potential that a voltage should go to the threshold voltage. Here's you that -50 is threshold voltage. When voltage will go to the -50 millivolt, then what happens? The cell in the cell membrane outside is positively charged. Then there's present of specific sodium voltage gate. In cell membrane, outside cell membrane, these are specific sodium voltage gate, and when the potential will go to the threshold, then it causes to the entry or influx of sodium. When sodium will enter to the cell membrane, then it causes to the positivity. Then it causes to the positivity into the cell, and a point will come that it is sufficient amount of the sodium, that this will be a sufficient amount of the sodium that more sodium will not enter into the cell membrane. What's the reason? Because that the intracellular membrane have also a gate which is known as the inactivated gate. When inactivated gate will be closed, then more sodium will not enter into the cell, and there will be sufficient amount of the sodium into the cell. What's the role of the sodium into the cell? When cell from -70 to reach to the -50, then sodium influx will be into the cell. When sodium influx into the cell, then it causes positivity. When it reaches to the positivity, then it's known as a depolarization. When it is known as a depolarization. Depolarization you can define as the voltage from negativity to positive. From negative to positive is known as a depolarization. From negative voltage to positive voltage, it is known as a depolarization. And the voltage of cell will reach at plus 30 millivolt, and this is known as a depolarization. At the plus 30 millivolt, it is a sufficient amount of the sodium that the more sodium will not enter into the cell membrane. So the intracellular or inactivated gate of the voltage gate will not allow the sodium entry into the cell, and more sodium will not enter into the cell. So this was about the influx of the sodium or depolarization. We know there is more sodium, also more potassium. So there in the cell there is a more positivity. When high concentration, according to electrochemical gradient, the ions will move from high concentration to low concentration, and potassium is nearly about of 150 equal in the liter, which will move from high concentration to low concentration. When potassium will move outside, when potassium will move outside with the help of a gate, then it causes to produce electronegativity into the cell, because the positive charge are going outside the cell membrane. The positive charge are going outside the cell membrane, and it causes to the increase of negativity into the cell. When positively charged will go outside the cell membrane, then inside the cell membrane more negatively voltage will be inside the cell membrane. This is known as a repolarization. For example, from positive to negative, it's known as a repolarization. So here sodium influx occur, so that from threshold potential the cell will go, the graph is going to upward, and this one is known as a depolarization. From this efflux mean the movement from inside to outside is occur, and from here potassium outflux will be, and this shows to the repolarization. But the resting membrane potential is -70, but it doesn't stop at the -70. It goes below to the -70. What's the reason behind this, that the cell goes below to -70? The reason is this, that the potassium channel takes some more time to close. When the potassium channel takes some more time to close, then the electronegativity will be high into the cell, and when the electronegativity will be high, then this known as a hyperpolarization. The repolarization will convert into hyperpolarization. Hyper mean high, and hyperpolarization mean more negativity into the cell. Then again cell will go toward the resting membrane potential. Again, in very simple words, from negativity to positive, it's known as a depolarization, because that the influx of the positively charged occur into the cell membrane, when the influx of the sodium or calcium or the positively charged will be occur into the cell membrane, then the negatively charged is changed into the positively charged. When the negatively charged will change into positively charged, then it is known as a depolarization. So it is known as a depolarization. But when the potential is goes nearly about to the 30 millivolt, the influx of the sodium will not occur because of the intracellular gate will be closed, and the due to electrochemical gradient, the potassium is in high amount into the cell and the potassium will go outside the cell membrane. So when the potassium will go outside the cell membrane, potassium is a positively charged. When the positive charge will go outside the cell membrane and the inside the cell membrane will be negatively, so it is going to the negatively charged. When it is going to the negatively charged, because from the positivity to negatively, it is known as a repolarization. When it is going to the repolarization, but it doesn't stop at the minus 70 millivolt, because the potassium channel takes some more time to close. So the repolarization is changed into the hyperpolarization. For example, in the simple word, resting membrane potential will change into threshold membrane potential. From threshold membrane potential, influx of the sodium will be occur, and this causes to the depolarization. When it goes to the plus 30 millivolt, then the outflux of potassium will be occur, and then depolarization will convert it into the repolarization. And potassium takes some more time, and it is not close nearly about of the 70 millivolt, it change into hyperpolarization. From the hyperpolarization, it again convert into resting membrane potential. So it is all about the action potential.